Sheri Reed, and I'm so glad to be with you today. I am here to do some art with you this week, next week, as many weeks as we want to do. And before I get arting today, I want to introduce you to my fellow artists, because you're going to hear from them at some point in the video. You just know how it is. So this is Aspen. We call her the Wonder Hound. She joined us about a year ago from the shelter, and we don't know what she is. She's some kind of houndy something something. She's very smart, and she's very alert to all things that move, and hence the wondrous barking. This, hey, Phoenix, she's joined us a couple of months ago, so she's just figuring us out. Her name is Phoenix. She's a coonhound, and she has a very deep bark, and she also wants to eat all things that run, so I'm sure we're going to hear from her as well. Aren't you? Yes, my sweet. Okay. All right, so on to the art. We are going to play with some finger paints because they are just so freeing and tactile, and they're just fun. So in the materials you have, you should go into the paint box and find these things. You'll need a palette, either one of these ones I've left you, it's a lid of a something, or a paper plate maybe. You'll need the medium-sized jars, bottles of finger paint. Those came in yellow, red, and blue. They feel squishy and slippery. And you'll find that there's a large pad of paper, and that paper is quite shiny. It's good because the paper lets the paint slide around on it. We took that paper and we cut it in half to make two smaller pieces, just so you'd have more opportunities to paint. But if you want, if you have a grand vision, go ahead, use the paper full size and go for it. I also provided a number of different acrylic paints. Now, while the finger paints are made to be very clothing friendly, and still I wouldn't smush them on your good blouse or anything, but these definitely are not clothing friendly. I have had to commit this little jumper thing. This acrylic paint will never come off this, but it will wash off your hands well. If you want to, if you really dislike the feeling of the paint, you can put on a pair of rubber gloves or you know, vinyl gloves. Oh, it's a dog. Shh. Hey, come here. Right. So you could do that. I was doing that yesterday and discovered that in the end, I couldn't seem to clean the gloves off well enough, and they just kept contaminating all the colors, so I ended up taking them off. Whatever works for you. You'll need some paper towel or an old rag to wipe your hands on so you can clean them up in between the colors, and maybe something to scrape into the paint. Maybe your nails, maybe the end, not the brush, but the end of a paintbrush is a nice clean surface. Or a fork that you're willing to clean super well. This is a plastic fork, obviously. You can drag the tines through or the big handle through, make some cool stuff. What did we make so far that I will show you how we did, just to give you some inspiration? First, we played with the colors. Aspen, sit. Good girl. We played with the colors. Really, I just squirted the paint on and mushed it around, and then used the end of my fork to carve into it. Then we got a little bit more intentional, smeared red all over, smeared some yellow in the middle, started wiping it around, and then using this to create shape. Then I went to Pinterest and got some inspiration from some professional artists, so I cannot take claim for this idea, but a beautiful skyscape with fields that this artist had created. And we tried to capture that. And then this morning, I fooled around with, I thought I was gonna be making that red flower thing again. I got a big blob of red on the paper and thought, oh, it looks like a face. okay, what can I do with that? So after I'd made the face, I just started making little drizzles of paint and dragging them around and then drawing in them with my tool, which is super cool because you ended up seeing all these different layers of the paint. So you got all the way back down to the red and the white and the blue. It's cool. So let's do these together. People yesterday in the group that was doing art with me, they had some wonderful ideas that I hadn't thought of. The idea of sort of making like a Rorschach blot where you make half the piece one color or one design and then fold it in half and then open it up and find out what you've got. And then there were the watercolor or the finger paints. I don't have any. I gave them all to the center, so I don't have them right now. But the finger paints work so beautifully when you start to trace into them with your fingers and pull it off the paper. It looks so nice. It doesn't work that great with the acrylics, but yeah, we'll see. So I am going to change cameras and we're going to start. I'm going to start with, if I were you, I would start with the finger paints because they do feel so wonderful. I am going to start with two colors. Do I know what I'm doing? No, I don't. I have no idea what I'm doing. I am just going to mush right into it. Now, if I mush it all together, of course, I get to mix the colors. I have noticed these particular acrylics I have, these are not super great acrylics, and when they mix, sometimes they just go really dark. So, let me see. I'm going to get all my fingers in. For a finger clean. All right, let's see. How about, I don't know. All right. I'm just going to see how well. See, I'm not using the right paper and I'm not using your paint, so when I scrape it off, it comes off. Not as well as yours will, though. Yours will come off beautifully. But the beauty of it is, if I don't like that, meh. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. What mistake in life has been so easy to fix? My goodness me. And I can do some other things. I'm now making a big purpley mess, but you know what? I don't care. I can even draw into it. I could write. I could say, I love dogs. I could say, oh my goodness, you know what? I was really angry at my neighbor yesterday. He mowed the lawn when I was trying to go to bed. Who mows the lawn at 10 at night? Seriously. Bob, be quiet. Oh, I feel better already. And yet, I do like Bob. I don't really want to tell Bob to be quiet, but I did last night. And I'm going to say goodbye to all this writing. And start again. And start again. And maybe I can make some writing that I like. You know what? I was learning how to do some calligraphy the other day. Believe it or not, that says soul. And then I'm gonna do power. teach math and science in junior high, and it's amazing. That's that age of students. Hey, babies. Don't know how to read cursive writing. It's like a mystery power if you can cursive write. Okay, soul. Here we go. I'm gonna drag my fork through it, see what I get there. Oh, that's kind of cool. Yay. Okay. Well, I think I've made a big enough mess with that one. I'm done. Okay, seriously. What could we be doing? Don't you grumble at me. They're grumbling at me. Okay, let's try another one. I want to try that blot technique. So I'm going to take my piece of paper and try that. It looked so interesting. I'm going to use some brights. Guess what I'm trying to make? Bet you can. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little smooshy. Ooh, that was very smooshy. And some more smooshy. And some more smooshy. Feel like I should not get this too skinny in the, you know. I feel like I should have left it the way it was to begin with. That's what I feel like. Oh well. Oh well. Hold on, maybe I can save it. Okay. I don't know, let's see. Have I totally wrecked it? Well, that does not look like I thought it was going to look. So, well, you know what? I think I'll just leave it. I'm just going to leave it. I like this part in the middle here. Maybe I'm gonna... Oh, I can't stand it. I can't stand it. I have to draw into it. Isn't that silly? I thought it would be interesting to draw into that part because there's so many layers of paint there. There's the blue and the green and the... I don't know. I think I should have left it alone. Oh well. Anyway, there it is. I'm going to stop. It was something interesting. Okay, now I'm going to try that flower. I kind of like how the flower turned out. So, with the flower, I covered pretty much the whole paper in red. I think I might have left the middle sort of paint-free for the yellow to come. But it's pretty thick paint. Now, the advantage to letting it be thick is it feels great. The other advantage to it being thick is it, when you wipe it off, it hasn't dried already. Because once it dries, then you can't move it around. And then you can't get back down to the white. You cannot get back down to the white of the paper. So, let's see. Here we go. I'm now going to clean my hand-ish and draw into this. And I think I'm going to have to clean it every time. Then do a little mushy here because I wanted that second row of petals. Aspen, that's enough, thank you. Heaven's sake, seriously. There is a magpie sitting on, right outside the door just to drive them crazy. Just to drive them crazy. But if I go and put them in another room, they will howl and it will not be happy. It will not be happy. See what I'm doing? I'm just sticking little bits of the yellow. throughout the painting so that the painting has some connection between that center and the rest. And let's see if we can make the center kind of fun. There we go. Okay, and we're done. Bye-bye. Baby, sorry dog. That nice hillside kind of thing in the background. There we go. And up here is going to be, I really don't want to draw this. I don't think you should draw it. So I'm not going to draw it. No kidding, Sheri. So what did we do? How about we lay down some blue. Let's do some blue.
plume. Et voilà, c'est une bleue.
Okay. Now, I'm going to add some white. Now, you know what? I think now is the time to start putting some white in here, along with a little bit of yellow. A little bit of red. Okay, so mostly white. Ooh, big blob of white. Okay, now I'm going to do some clouds. Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of red and white, mix up some pretty pink, ooh, and I'm going to add that in. And I'm going to add some white and yellow. Let's see what happens there. And steal some blue. Some blue, mix some of that green. Ooh, green. Okay, now I'm going to add some of that down here. Okay, then. You can mix or use some of the greeny color. No, let's just do all of this. But remember, parts of this we want to have parts of this be dark and far away and lighter. So I gotta do that here. We're gonna add some dark. Dippity dippity dip. Gonna have a little bit of white, a little bit of blue, a little bit of white, a little bit of blue, a little bit of white, a little bit of blue, a little bit of blue. This on top here. Nice. On top there. Do, do, do. And a little bit of pink. And then I'm going to make some yellow here. So I'm using white and yellow. And I'm going to do it here where the sun is hitting. And then I'm going to bring some darker stuff, like grass. And then, all right, the fun stuff. Here we go. A little bit of orange. Gonna use some orange. Let's see, there we go. And a little bit of purple. Oops. Purple. No, no, no. Okay, here we go. I am going to put a little bit of yellow orange. Yellow orange. Yellow orange. I'm going to make little flowers with little dots right here. Okay, and then I'm going to make these red flowers. Yeah, these red flowers. Okay.
I'm gonna do rub. Really good, Bob. Thing. And a thing. That's pretty easy. And then I'm gonna make another one. Thing. And a thing. And a thing. And I'm gonna make another one. A thing. And a thing. And a thing. Okay. Then I'm gonna use the orange. Orange. And I'm gonna do a thing. And a thing. And a thing. And then in the middle we're going to take a little dab of blue and put a dab of blue in there. Okay, little dab of blue. Little dab of blue. Okay. And then we've got some flowers. Yay. And then I could even take this and I could add some definition to that. Okay, so now that's that whole thing done. Okay. So we're all done now. I have a big mess. I have many new things on my clothes, and we're ready to go. Bye! I hope you had fun. Be sure to take a photo of your stuff and show it to Kemi so that I can, or let Kemi take a photo of your stuff so that I can celebrate your experience. See you next week.